Today, the House committee responsible for impeachment proceedings sent the president a message, 81 letters to nearly every person, institution, and business entity connected to Donald J. Trump, signaling the president is about to face more scrutiny on more fronts than any president ever has. We're putting them up on the screen, and as you can see, Eric and Donald Trump Jr. on the list, David Pecker, who runs the National Enquirer's parent company, the Karen McDougal payoff guy, Trump Organization CFO Alan Weisselberg is there, COO Matthew Calamari, the president's former personal secretary, Corey Lewandowski, and others. The Trump Organization itself, the president's discredited charity, they're all getting letters from the committee requesting documents. So are campaign officials Michael Flynn, members of the inaugural committee, Jared Kushner, Hope Hicks. There are Russian billionaires on the list, Julian Assange, people involved in the Trump Tower meeting, the Judiciary Committee. They want information from all of these people and entities. It is, by any measure, a daunting list, and as you can see, the names go on. Together, they know more things about more specific aspects of the president and his dealings, some going back decades. So if there's anything fishy with any of it, they would probably be in a position to know. Yet today, when asked whether he'd cooperate with the committee, the president preferred to focus on one aspect of the investigation.
I cooperate all the time with everybody. And you know the beautiful thing? No collusion. It's all a hoax. You're going to learn about that as you grow older. It's a political hoax. There's no collusion. There's no anything.
No collusion, no anything. That is, of course, the president's longstanding refrain, and it very well may be true. Might not. That's what Robert Mueller's report will likely, hopefully, settle. But tonight, that's not the point, because keep it honest, whatever you may think of the president or his actions, whether as president or before, it's not just a question of collusion, it's also potentially obstruction of justice, perhaps witness tampering as well. And during his testimony last week, Michael Cohen suggested numerous other items for Congress and law enforcement to look into, including fraud on the president's part.
In conversations we had during the campaign, at the same time I was actively negotiating in Russia for him, he would look me in the eye and tell me there's no Russian business, and then go on to lie to the American people by saying the same thing. In his way, he was telling me to lie.
Well, Cohen also shed light on efforts he made to silence Stormy Daniels and Karen McDougal and the apparently deceptive way in which he was paid for his work, which may have violated campaign finance law, with the president's knowledge.
That was in order to hide what the payment was. I obviously wanted the money in one shot. I would have preferred it that way. But in order to be able to put it onto the books, Alan Weisselberg made the decision that it should be paid over the 12 months so that it would look like a retainer.
And did Mr. Trump know about this reimbursement method?
Oh, he knew about everything, yes.
Well, Cohen says he knew and suggested the names of people, such as Alan Weisselberg, that lawmakers should contact, many of whom are now getting letters from the Judiciary Committee. And on top of that, he also put fresh focus on other allegedly questionable practices, some of which reportedly date back decades for the president, including this.
To your knowledge, did the president ever provide inflated assets to an insurance company?
Yes.
Who else knows that the president did this?
Alan Weisselberg, Ron Lieberman, and Matthew Calamari.
And where would the committee find more information on this? Do you think we need to review his financial statements and his tax returns in order to compare them?
Yes, and you'd find it at the Trump Org.
Although we do not know specifically what the House Judiciary Committee is seeking from the Trump Organization, we do know that the company either has or is about to get a letter in the mail. And there's more tonight, including another avenue that a number of leading conservatives believe could lead to impeachment on its own, with nothing added. It involves the president reportedly leaning on the Justice Department to block a business deal involving our parent company because, again, reportedly, the president didn't like CNN's coverage of him. We'll talk about that. We'll talk about all the other ways the president could now be vulnerable, either legally or politically or both. And you'll hear from some who call this kind of wide-ranging scrutiny long overdue, and those who disagree say it's completely unfair. What you won't hear is anyone who's downplaying how serious this potentially is, except perhaps the president.
Now we have people that lost, and unfortunately, you put the wrong people in a couple of positions, and they leave people for a long time that shouldn't be there, and all of a sudden, they're trying to take you out with bullshit, okay? With bullshit.
excuse the language. CNN's Jim Acosta joins us now from the White House with more on how the president is reacting to the apparently widening investigation. So any word from the White House on this?
Not much, Anderson. Just that little bit of audio that you played just a short while ago where the president said that he cooperates with everybody. The White House press secretary did issue a brief statement saying that Chairman Nadler of the Judiciary Committee knows full well that some of the things he's seeking are protected by law as private conversations that the president and some of his aides have as they're doing the people's business inside the White House. But Anderson, that is an indication when the White House says something like that, that they're going to try to stand in the way of cooperating with this investigation, which is no BS, no matter what the president says.
So they plan to assert executive privilege at some point.
It does seem to be that case. That, you know, the White House has not pulled that trigger up until this point. I talked to a White House official earlier this evening who said the president has not made a decision about that. Although, if you look at exactly what Chairman Nadler's committee is seeking at this point, a lot of this falls under the area that, according to this White House official, falls under executive privilege. Now, whether or not they go down that road, we'll have to wait and see what happens with that. If you remember what happened with Matt Whitaker, the acting attorney general, he went up and testified up on Capitol Hill, was viewed by many Democrats as not being terribly cooperative and really not a productive witness. And so the White House could go down that road where they try to obfuscate and drag things out and perhaps flood the zone with as much documentation and information as possible as a way to jam up this investigation. But I talked to one of the targets of this probe, one of the names on that list who didn't want to speak on the record, but was basically saying, listen, you know, if there's one cautionary tale on all this, if you're going to go work for a campaign or an administration, it's best to hire a lawyer beforehand. And Anderson, I would suspect if you're a white-collar attorney here in Washington dealing with government corruption, defending clients who've been accused of government corruption, your phone's probably ringing off the hook this week.
Anderson. Yeah, I mean, other White Houses, you know, would set up elaborate war rooms staffed with a lot of people in order to deal with things like this. Do we know if this White House has anything like that in place?
No signs of that, Anderson. And one of the things that we can point to is what happened last week with Michael Cohen when the president was over in Vietnam with that summit with Kim Jong-un. It was almost deafening silence coming out of the White House and out of the president's team over in Hanoi when we were asking these questions about Michael Cohen. Remember, Michael Cohen brought up a whole slew of these issues that are now falling under Chairman Nadler's investigation, going into the president's business dealings, the Trump Organization. I mean, you name it, Michael Cohen was basically pointing a finger at it, you know, how the president was shielding himself from paying taxes and paying high insurance rates on his personal properties and his golf properties and so on. And there just wasn't anybody inside the White House who was willing to field those questions. And my guess is, Anderson, dealing with the Nadler investigation, we're going to have some more of that same deafening silence. It's another way of dealing with the questions. You can set up a war room sort of like they did back in the Clinton administration, or you can have no war room and not talk to anybody, which might be what happens, Anderson.
Yeah. Jim Acosta, appreciate it from the White House. Thanks very much.